Base44 just hit 2 million users and released a brand new app platform with some powerful features that makes building a lot easier. In this video, we are going to put the new app platform to the test and see if we can build a complex app. This is what we're going to be building. It is a social post generator. It generates the text for posts and the images for posts. And then we have a campaign builder where you can build out campaigns for multiple platforms, as many posts as you want, and it will generate text and image for each of your social posts that it generates. Thank you to Base44 for sponsoring this video. Click the link in the description to try Base44 for yourself 100% for free. Let's jump in. So the prompt I'm going to use is create a social media post generator. Should produce engaging posts with customizable templates and trending hashtags. For styling instructions, I'm gonna go with neomorphism for this one. And that's something that's nice about Base44 is you can just click this and select one of their preset styling instructions, which just gives your app a nice unique design right off the bat. And what it does is then append that prompt of the design to the actual prompt. So if you did wanna go in and change it, you could. But we're gonna go ahead and stick with that and send this off. So the new builder from Base44 is supposed to think more before building. It's supposed to pull context from multiple sources, debug intelligently, and make better architectural decisions as it's writing your code. So we're gonna put it to the test in this video and see if we really get better results. Now, if this works, it's going to solve a big problem that a lot of you may have come across when you've built with vibe coding tools before, which is you start building your idea, you get stuck, and the vibe coding tool just isn't able to resolve it. But a lot of these issues should be able to be resolved with better thinking before actually writing code and trying to think about the architecture and just better planning. And that's what Base44's new builder promises. So right off the bat, there is an error and all we have to do is just click resolve with AI, and then Base44 should be able to easily resolve. That's a nice feature that Base44 has, is just to be able to easily resolve with AI with one click. We're gonna build a bunch of features in this video to really put this new builder to the test. And here we are with the first version of our app. Really cool design that it generated. And let me quickly show you some of the dashboard features of Base44 before we test it out. So just in a second, we're gonna test this out. Here we have the database. So by default, the database and the users are all built in to Base44. So you don't need to have a separate app or platform like Superbase. It's all built in. Analytics is built in too, which is really nice. And there's other more advanced features like agents that we might get into later in the video. But here, just with the data tab, we can see there are posts, but we haven't actually created one yet. So the database is empty. So let's test this out. Let's do a Twitter post. Let's say it's promotional. Let's say it is the new Base44 app builder. So we want to create a post for this. And then I just added some additional context about what the new builder can do. So we'll go ahead and click generate post. And what's nice about Base44 is it has AI functionality built into the platform. The AI integration is all connected. It's just going to be part of the package of your monthly plan with Base44. So here we have our generated post. It thinks we're over the limit, but Twitter X now does not have a limit. So that could be a feature that we're gonna add in a second. Let's just test out what happens if I click copy. So it copies to my clipboard. Can I click save? And I don't know where it saved, but it said it saved. A couple of things for us to start continuing to build on. A quick prompt here, remove the character limit from Twitter and then also asking what happens when I click save post. I don't see a place to view my saved posts. So let's see what Base44 is able to come up with here. As we can see here, it's building two different pages at once and editing both these pages. So that's something that's cool that I can see, that it's able to do more than one thing at the same time. As it removed the character limit from Twitter, so why don't we go ahead and test that and let's do the same prompt again. I can see there's no limit on characters. It was able to work perfectly. And then let's click save post. And then if I click view save posts, now I can see the posts that I saved are there, which is perfect. And I should be able to delete it as well. And yes, now it is removed from my saved posts, which is awesome. Next thing that I'm gonna test is web search. So Base44 says that the new editor is going to decide when it should search the web for more information and use that as it's building. So I'm going to test this by writing a prompt that's very specific. So the prompt that I'm giving is to please search the web for best practices in writing X or Twitter posts in 2025, and then update the system prompt to improve our results when we actually use the app. So I can see here right off the bat, it searched for best practices writing X Twitter posts in 2025. So that's pretty cool. It did search the web. And of course, this was an example where we were very explicit about searching the web. But it should work, let's say, if you're wanting to connect an API and said, hey, look up the API documentation for this tool. It should also work for something like this. And then it should use this and update our prompt, and then we'll test it again and see if we get some better results here in our actual app. Right, so it made an update, and now let's test it out again and see if we get a different result from what we did before, and hopefully it's better. And let's go ahead and save the post and then just view our saved posts and just to compare real quick. My opinion, I do think it is a better result. Something here, I think we used way too many emojis in the initial version. This version feels a lot cleaner, which I definitely like a lot more. And then I also like how it has these individual lines here after the bullet points. So overall, I do think the new version was better. So just a really simple example of how we could have our AI do research about something to improve our app and then implement that inside of the app itself. So now we're going to try out another feature that I see here in Base44 called suggestions. And we're going to click on AI content analysis. And what that's going to do is build an entire prompt here that we can review and then decide if we want to send it off based on this suggestion. Like this idea, enhance the AI capabilities to analyze the generated posts to basically give us more suggestions. So why don't we go ahead and send that off and see what result we get. So we're going to try this generate post again, and it should have AI generated feedback on the post, which then we can use to automatically improve it as well. So this is pretty cool. I'm curious what it comes up with. So here we have a post analysis. This is all, again, using the OpenAI integration into Base44. So we didn't have to connect to build in this AI functionality. You can build AI apps really easily with Base44. And here, basically, we have some post analysis, engagement, readability, sentiment, strengths, and then suggestions for improvement. You can even regenerate it with the improvement suggestions that it's giving you. So pretty cool that it was able to add all of that. Now we're going to move into the discuss mode. And let's ask the AI for some ideas of additional features. So with discuss mode, you can chat with the AI without having the AI actually write code for you. So it's a great way to plan things out and brainstorm ideas. Doing that, let me quickly show you in the database that we have our posts. And here, this is what I mean when I say everything is integrated in one platform. All of our posts are here saved in our database. So the first suggestion, image media integration, let's go ahead and do that. I like that idea to generate images for our posts. I'm not totally sure how high quality it's going to be, but let's try it out. So I'm going to send this off, and in a minute, you're going to see how well this was able to generate this feature. So it built in this feature where you can now click generate image with AI, and it wants me to describe the image. But I want to take this to the next level. I would like the AI to come up with that prompt for me because it should already have context from the topic and context. So I just wrote a prompt to basically ask it to do that for us. And you'll notice that when I write prompts, I try to be really specific and give examples of what I don't want and what I do want. And that helps the AI get better results. So here we can see it's searching for best practices for AI prompt generation because I asked it to do that, which I think is a really great way to get better results when you're building an AI app. It's just make sure you're searching for the best practices with prompting. Okay, so now we have this new feature where the AI is going to generate the image automatically without us having to write the prompt for it. So let's try this for a new product. Simple prompt of leather wallet and a high quality leather wallet is now 25% off or 20% off. And that's pretty cool. So it just generated the image and it did that before we actually generated our post. If we exited out, we could do another one. We could say blue leather wallet and generate with AI. And now we have our blue leather wallet design. So let's generate the post and then see how it all comes together. And now we have our full generated post for Instagram. Here we have our image and our description. And if we save this, let's just see if that image is also saved to our saved posts. And it looks like it is, which is awesome. So cool. That is all here in one place. And again, we didn't have to add any additional API connections for this image generation. It's all built in to Base44. So now we're going to build an even more advanced feature, and this is really putting the Base44 new builder to the test. So far, I've been really impressed. It hasn't got stuck with any bugs so far. It's been able to take care of every feature I've asked for. This one is going to be introducing a feature to generate a series of interconnected posts for a campaign. So I'm going to send this off and let's see how Base44 handles it. So essentially, the AI should create a sequence of posts that build upon each other, maintaining consistent messaging across the entire campaign. All right, so the feature is done. And this is really cool because I feel like now we're building out a more fully fleshed out app. So if we go to the campaigns tab, now we have the ability to generate full campaigns. So it's not just generating individual posts, which we still have the ability to do, but now we can do campaigns. So let's create our first campaign. All right, so really basic campaign, Black Friday sale, 40% off for a wallet company. 5 posts, Twitter, X, and Instagram, and professional yet witty for brand voice and target audiences, millennials. So let's create the campaign and generate posts and see how this goes. This is really cool. I can start to see how this is something I could actually see myself using. Generating one post is cool, but generating a whole campaign at once and doing that in a structured way is really valuable. So we have our draft. It created 5 posts, a combination between Instagram and Twitter. Now, the one thing that it didn't do is generate images, and I didn't have the ability to generate any images. So I'd love for it to do that. So I'm going to add that as a feature. So I'm just asking it to add that feature so we can generate images with the campaign posts automatically. And one more thing that's cool is if we go back, we can see the campaign is saved here. So we can go back and get back to our campaign. Okay, so it says it did it. Again, it did this in the first try. So let's go ahead and go back to our campaigns. And let's try to create a new one and see if we get those image results. So we're going to click Create Campaign and Generate Posts. They did a very similar prompt for all of the details as the first time. So it seems like it generated it, but it didn't generate the images. So this is a great opportunity for us to test out another feature of the new Base44 platform, which is its debugging feature. So it's supposed to be able to check our logs and automatically fix errors a lot more easily. So I'm sending a prompt that the campaign generated text posts, but I don't see the images if they were generated at all. Can you look into our logs and help me debug this? Here I can see the tools it was using. It was reading our database. It can see that none of the images were actually created. So now it's telling us to try again. It has better console logs, and we should be able to at least diagnose the issue a little bit better. So let's try this out. Now this time I'm just going to publish the app so I can open it in a new window and use my console logs. So here it's published. What's cool about Base44 is user authentication is all built in, so we don't have to worry about any of that. So let's go to campaigns and let's try this one more time. So we're going to try this one more time, but now on the right side, I have my console log open. You can get to that by right-clicking on Chrome, going to Inspect, and then clicking Console here on the top. So hopefully now we're going to get some better results. And I see here it says generating image. We did seem to get a result, so maybe it just was able to fully solve it. But it's cool here in the console log, we can see exactly what is happening. So first it's generating the images, and here we go. This time it fully worked. So actually this was resolved with the actual changes that Base44 made. We didn't even have to give it our console log errors because there were no errors. So here we have our images and our text for each of these posts. Very cool that it was able to build this out, do it automatically. Of course, these might not be something you want to post right away, but there's still more iteration we could do to improve the quality of the post, make it match your brand guidelines. There's a lot more we could add on to this, but at a base level, really cool that this was able to generate a campaign and create 5, or we could create 20 posts all at once. I hope that you enjoyed this video and were inspired by what you can build with Base44. And I personally was impressed by the new Base44 builder. It really did a good job of planning things out, debugging when there were errors, and building out a pretty complex app in a really short period of time. If you want to build more with Base44, click the link in the description. You can start building for free and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more videos like this. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.